Nestled in the valley between the Titiwangsa Range and the Sitol Hills lies the old wooden tin mining village of Kampong Hakka Mantin. The Sitol River, which once brought down the rich tin ore from the hill slopes, is now a pale shadow of its former glory. The village has a rich history dating back to the late 19th century, which saw a great influx of Chinese workers brought in as indentured labour by the colonial government to work in the tin industry. They were mainly poor and desperate people facing adverse conditions for their survival. Life was neither safe nor was it much respected. These early pioneers with limited resources, working with simple implements, facing hardship and hostile terrain, built their homes, temple and school, which formed the early settlement of Kampong Hakka. But this village is now under threat of demolition. Grandma Kong's family is one of the last few families still living here, safeguarding the history, culture, and tradition which their ancestors fought hard to build.
我婆就总结啊，带阿爸、带阿叔、带阿哥啊，两日为门店，两日为天日记耶，两日为钱工作咯，两日为就来请阿妈咯，我阿公都带阿妈来两日为拍家村，两日为天记咯，两日为金箔阿达嘛，什么人两日为求哎，什么阿达木来，当两日为求哎是客家村啦，阿婆来时候啊，什么嘿有酱啊，啊要起来做毛缝毛火来来天来啊。 毛货什么就那点货水电的哦，爱打水哦，毛水货毛用来毛出来水哦，啊，毛饭啊，就用柴哦。天时啊，什么人啊，就那坐脚踩哦，行路啊，啊，那个一追柴，捡油柴咯，毛么个柴哦，一头毛都毛困过呀，天时。
Unlike those who have come to exploit the natural resources and left, the folks at Kampong Hakka are descended from those who stayed on, to continue to toil on the land and eke out a simple living over the last 100 years. Every member of the family, young and old, contributes to its well-being.
Ngamak
The geology and natural geography of the Sittle River Valley provided the early Chinese settlers with most of the elements for their decision to put down roots in Kampong Hakka.
13岁啊，13岁啊，一只船都来到雅门边，雅门边边，每一只船门边跨到左铁船沿江嘛，有两只凤凰人啊，一只猴狗，一只猴哥爷，一只炸燕子，即系唐人啊，闽南人来，所以有屋企桥嘛，佢企住炸燕子喎，叫搵人啊，顺便入去啊客家村一人去解床一人客家村而做，一嚟叫啊。
Besides the rich alluvial tin, the soil was also suitable for rubber plantation, fruit orchards, and vegetable farming. To provide for their families, these villagers often had to work from dawn to dusk, doing menial tasks that most people shun today. However, despite their busy daily work routine, there was still time for friendship and romance.
嗰时咧，个孙咯，就那位遇杂人咧，好便宜哇！是嘛咩？出一个外国，每一晚要出啲工啦，嘛系咪啊？用工烧咯，工咯，工硬嘅就仓库咧，梯架要存人来咧，就认识佢，认识即系无谈恋爱啦。仲系家平要夹乜哦？工烧工烧人咯，我当咪就二十一岁，同二十岁啦，就结婚咯，系咯。
我结婚咧，出去请下紧木桥咯，有50年桥，40年桥多见啦，桥喺60几年咯，又咁我去亚嘅咯，我木靠。啊，结婚咧请下木靠咧，嚟到出上去接特子路个，有啲集用梯啦，用梯叫集哦，用梯三集拉，用梯六集摩哟，是嘛请下啲用梯啊，紧木有啲长梯咯。
From a cluster of basic wooden houses, the residents of Kampong Hakka over time built a thriving community, deeply rooted in tradition and culture, with a temple, a primary school, community hall, several shops, and even a burial site to honor their ancestors. The villagers survived the war years despite the harsh living conditions, but many still lost their lives. But their troubles did not end even after the occupation.
日本仔接翻时嗰下，一空嘅紧要来哦，空嘅时候咧来就送波来哦，是嘛先时日本仔采起佢落个山呢喎，咁咪就要条江咧就出咗来哦，出咗来就探下啲人啊，要一矿山洞啊，咁咯，又先时日本仔喺度安排啊，是嘛做哦，是嘛做佢晒起，又俾民地都做个下集哦，去做晒起哦。
After independence, the folks of Kampong Hakka were able to continue their livelihood, forging strong bonds amongst themselves and with their neighbouring community. Together with other villages such as Kampong Mantin, a Malay village nearby, also with its humble beginnings, they form the multicultural township of Mantin. The situation of this village is now extremely unpredictable and precarious. This community, once thriving, is now under threat. Recently, many of the families have been evicted and their homes destroyed, while many houses have been abandoned and left in disrepair. The villagers have been denied their rightful ownership to their ancestral land due to administrative irregularities.
I think the Kampong Hakka folks were not treated fairly by the fact that they have been living there for over 100 years, and they do have documentation to show that they were living there, that they were paying assessment rates, electricity bills, water bills. Everything appears to be legitimate up to the point where someone acquired their land and wants to build over it.
Mantin Kekia Chun的这个土地问题，如果发生在雪兰莪州，就不会这样了。因为雪兰莪州政府，如果人民住过超过十二年，我们就优先给他们这个土地。
How did these villagers, whose forebears came as early settlers or pioneers to work on the land more than 100 years ago, be suddenly rendered as squatters, turning them into criminals for protecting their homes? Many villagers and friends have come together to fight this human rights violation and to safeguard this historical and cultural landscape. Rakan Mantin is a community initiative to promote and protect this historical and cultural landscape from indiscriminate destruction.
Rakan Mantin is a community initiative to promote and protect this historical and cultural landscape from indiscriminate destruction. 同發展商面對搬遷的問題啦。
These buildings and settlements in which our ancestors lived, thought, worked and prayed are history with many dimensions, powerful in our imagination to remind people who they are and to resist authorities' power to define them as something else. Squatters, pendatang. Today, there are not many Malaysian landscapes like Kampong Hakka, with families going back six generations. This is one of the last remaining examples of an early Chinese migrant settlement. Their hard work, determination and community spirit is still strong, and they are staying for as long as they can to fight for land justice, hoping for the day that they can stay without insecurity and fear of being chased away, their homes demolished and their stories erased without a trace. This traditional community represents years of hard labour, living with a hope for a brighter future for the next generation. For them, it's a resistance not just to the loss of their homes and land, it is a loss of their over 100 years historical and cultural heritage and way of life.
Don't lie, don't lie, and you how some.